Welcome to North U Kids TV. We are so glad that you can join us. My name's Abby, and I'll be hanging out with you a little bit more this summer. But to help me, I have a new special friend. Everyone, welcome Word Bird. That was so nice of your cousin to provide you with dinner when you were so hungry. Did you know that just like how your cousin provided you food when you were hungry, God always provides us with what we need? That is such a good question, Word Bird. I think we have a teacher coming soon who can help teach you a story of a time where God's people had a battle against their enemies and God provided for them, allowing them to win. Should we grab a snack and a blanket and a comfy corner and we can hear our Bible lesson together? Did you say Smarties? That sounds like a good idea. Let's go.
Hey friends, welcome to our Bible story time. My name is Jed and I have some fuzzy friends here with me today. What are you guys' names?
Hello, my name is Mirabel and I'm from Colombia and I'm here to share the good news with my little cousin Primito and his name is Miguelito.
Miguel.
It's actually Miguel, but I call him Miguelito because he's so small.
Yes, I am small, but like my name is Miguel and one day I'll be as big as like my dad. And I'm from Colombia. And my favorite baseball team is the Dodgers. That's why I'm blue.
That's why you're blue, because you like the Dodgers.
Yes.
Oh, wow. Well, we're here for an amazing Bible story today about God's strength.
Oh, Woo! My goodness. I've heard about God's strength and how it's so, so, so amazing.
It is so amazing. So, are you ready to start our Bible story?
Simon.
All right, let's jump into it. So, you remember that God's people, the Israelites, were led out of Egypt by Moses, and they crossed the Red Sea, and they were in the wilderness.
Of Of course I remember that story.
Yep. And for 40 years, the Israelites wandered through the wilderness, and Moses grew old, and Joshua was chosen to be Moses' successor and lead the Israelites.
And where did he take the people? Like, he's leading them somewhere, right? You go on a journey?
I know, they're going on a journey. They're going to the promised land that God had promised for them. So, we'll get to that in a little bit. After Moses had died, the Lord spoke to Joshua. This is what he said. Get ready now, you and the people of Israel, to cross the River Jordan into the land that I am giving you. Joshua, no one will be able to defeat you as long as you live. I know. And as I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will always be with you. So
Joshua sounds strong. Like as strong as like God almost even?
I don't know if he's as strong as God. I don't think anybody's as strong as God.
That makes sense.
Yeah. So Joshua ordered the leaders of the 12 tribes to go through the camp to tell the people. They said, get ready, for soon we are going to cross the Jordan and occupy the land that the Lord your God is giving you.
Wait a second. Wait. God gave the people the land?
Like a gift?
He did. He promised them the land. The Israelites finally arrived in the promised land named Canaan. Can you say Canaan?
Canaan!
But there was one little teeny problem with Canaan.
What? What was it?
There were already people living there.
No way!
I know.
What? So what happened?
God's people couldn't just walk in there and set up their tents. They had to go to battle and win against their enemies.
Yeah, I guess I couldn't just go and live with Miguelito. Like, I would have to, like, make him dinner or something beforehand.
Yeah, and, like, call first, though, to let me know you're coming.
Yeah, the Israelites couldn't call first. But what they could do was they could send two spies into the city of Jericho to see what
it
was like.
Only two?
But, like, if the spies are going in, how are they getting all the people out?
Well, we'll have to wait and see, right? So the spies that Joshua sent stayed in the house of a woman named Rahab. Can you say Rahab?
Rahab.
And Rahab had heard about God and believed in him. And she wanted to help his people.
Aww.
Who were God's people? Do you know?
Like us?
No, like the people, like the tribe of Israel?
The Israelites, that's right. The Israelites are God's people. When the king of Jericho was looking for the spies in Jericho, she hid the men on the roof.
What? Like,
that's
like
terrible.
The roof?
Yeah.
Like
that's
up there?
A terrible
that's
hiding
no
spot.
That's no way.
I don't know. Cause it
so what happened?
Well, it seemed like it was a good hiding place because it worked. Rahab said to the spies, please be kind to my family since I have been kind to you. When you attack Jericho, please do not kill us. So the spies promised to keep Rahab and her family safe.
Aww.
Well, like, that's the least they could do because she saved their life too, you know?
Yeah, they did get saved by Rahab. So, do you want to know what happens next?
Yes.
Yeah. When the Israelites arrived, the people of Jericho hid behind the city's strong walls.
Whoa.
Yeah. Well, how do you think they're going to get inside? Do you have any guesses?
Like, find a gate and pick
the
lock.
Maybe they could find a gate and pick the lock. God had a better plan.
Oh. Of course he did.
Do you want to hear what God's plan was?
Yeah.
Is it make him powerful?
We'll have to see. God told Joshua how to conquer the city. Joshua would lead the people to march around the city one time every day for 6 days.
No way! Like almost a week of marching?
Almost a
Whoa,
week of marching.
Now we're really getting somewhere.
I know.
We have spies, and we have marching. And we have this lady who's hiding these spies in the roof. Wow, this is like a movie. So when does the wall actually fall down?
I think we'll have to wait and see. I think it's coming up. On the seventh day, the people of Israel would march around the city 7 times. And the priests would blow their horns. What do you think those horns sounded like?
Da-da!
Maybe they sounded like that. And all the people would shout, and the walls of Jericho would crumble to
Wait,
the ground.
Hold on. Like, this story is pretty cool, but like, I don't know if someone can blow a trumpet like loud enough for it to knock a wall down. Cause like, walls are big and strong.
So it wasn't the horns that made the walls fall, and it wasn't the people that made the walls fall.
What
do you think made the walls fall?
What? Wait, they marched and they shouted and they blew their trumpets? How can it not be the people?
Well, do you remember what God told them to do? He told them to do exactly that, and they did exactly that, and it was God's strength who brought the walls down. The people of Israel obeyed God's word, and God gave them the land that he had promised them.
That's a great story. Like, God comes through because he's powerful. Mm-hmm. My only question is, like, where's the Rahab lady? Because she's still there, right?
That is a great question. They kept Rahab and her family safe because she helped the spies. They kept their promise, and Rahab and her family lived with the Israelites from then.
Phew.
Wow.
I know. God was with Joshua, and everyone in the land knew of Joshua and what God had done through him.
Wow, you're so right. God is so strong. He totally brought down that wall.
I know. So you see, by faith, Rahab believed God would win the battle. When the Israelites attacked Jericho, Rahab and her family received mercy and became a part of God's people. Does this story sound a little bit familiar?
It seems like Jesus obeyed God.
That is right. This reminds us of Jesus. Wow. Jesus has won against every sin and death, and everyone who trusts in Jesus receives mercy and becomes a part of God's family forever.
Amen.
Wow. Just like Miguelito and I are a family.
Yeah,
we become part of God's family if we trust in Jesus. And you know what? That was such a good story.
I loved it. I know. Thank you so much for helping me. I think we should go, I don't know, what should we do?
Well, I was thinking about quesadillas.
And, quesadillas.
Miguelito, we should go make some quesadillas.
I love
and
quesadillas.
And what was your name again, teacher?
My name is Jed.
Oh, Jed.
It
you
was
can
nice
come
meeting
and join
you,
us.
Mr. Jed.
Okay, let's go have some quesadillas.
Ciao.
Hasta luego.
The shackles off my feet. time to learn our Unit 8 memory verse. The words are going to be on the screen, and I'm going to do the actions, so I'd love if you stood up on your feet and did it with me. Here we go. You are the God who does miracles. You show your power among the nations. Psalm 77, verse 14. Awesome, let's do it one more time, but this time even louder. Here we go. You are the God who does miracles. You show your power among the nations. Psalm 77, verse 14. Awesome job. Happy memorizing.
Against us, our God is for us. Sing with joy.